now, though. If you are sat there thinking, oh, school holidays, I bet those teachers are taking it easy, got their feet up, don't know they're bored. Well, you'd be wrong, particularly when it comes to my next guest, Andrew Wood, is a senior
local school
teacher.
Cycling from Eastbourne to the Lake District. Now, his journey takes place over the Easter weekend. It raises money for the Beachy Head Chaplaincy, which saves lives by talking to people potentially vulnerable to suicide at Beachy Head. Let's talk to Andrew Wood, who's the head teacher at Roedean Moira House School.
Joining me on the show, a senior teacher at Roedean School who swapped the classroom this Easter for the open road, and quite a lot of it too.
The first time I found out that I was going to be doing the bike ride, and it was more a question of me finding out rather than me thinking about it, was because we have a new lady here who's working with us called Dinah, and she's working in the PR. And in a meeting, I naively said that I ride my bike quite a lot and do a bit of exercise, and I was talking really passionately at the time about the school's history and how they used to be in the Lake District, and it was quite a long way away and other bits and pieces. And she put two and two together for me and said, that's what you need to do. This will be great photo shots. This will be great for the newspaper. This will be great for the school. And by the way, you don't have much of a say in it. You're going to do it. The reaction when I went home and from my family, when I told them that I was going to be doing this ride, was very supportive. Both my wife Cassie and Oscar, very supportive. I know it's going to be hard. I know it's going to be quite grueling because I've never done 3 days. I've done two big ones. I think more of the concern, more than a worry, is the factors that I can't control. The weather, the wind, the rain, the temperature. If something goes wrong on the way, I do have some support. That is in the form of Simon Hicks, who's the operations manager here. He's going to be very kindly driving the school minibus. He's going to be our support vehicle, my support vehicle. And I'm going to try and put as many things in there as possible. If I break a wheel or something, Simon will be there. So he will be the person that's going to hopefully give me food, shout at me when I'm feeling tired, or encourage me when I need more support.
Okay, so it's 10:15 on the first night, Saturday night. This morning we left the school. Thanks everybody for being there. We left the school at about 8:10. We arrived at the ferry port at, what was it time, at about 6 o'clock in the evening. Hopped across, went to the school, took some pictures of the old school. We're here on Morecambe Bay for tonight. We had a wonderful time. We had peacocks cheering in the background, and day one proper starts tomorrow. And all right, let's see if we can do it. Catch you tomorrow. Bye.
So day one, Morecambe Bay, stunning shot, beautiful location, good to go. And there he is. He's ready. And off he goes.
Day two, feeling very tired, feeling yesterday was a huge day. Started off beautifully, coming out of the Lake District was lovely, but our first 100k, 4.5 hours went well, and then we went through Preston and Warrington and all of the main roads. That was quite tough, that was hard going. The legs feel fine at the minute, but I haven't got on the bike, and I've got another 208 to go today. So I hope today will just be today and end quickly. Yeah, I don't feel great now at the moment. I'll see how I feel in the next hour, but I'm just gonna plod along today, I think, and try and eat more fuel. Yeah, the plan of attack is if I do this, it means stop, get the tow rope out and pull me for the next 40K.
I'll keep smiling.
Okay. And just to get this on record, you're going to listen to what Mr. Hicks is saying today, aren't you?
I always listen to everybody.
Liar. There he goes. Day two. Not in the best frame of mind today. Good luck.
Now, without getting personal, what hurts the most, the legs, the arms, or the backside?
Good question. Probably, I'll tell you what, none of those. Probably my feet.
Okay, your feet. Fair enough.
Yeah, my feet.
Day two was a lot better than day one.
Good.
A lot better. Beautiful. It was very, very beautiful riding. Lovely countryside. A34 was especially hairy when someone parks a minibus right on the inside lane and I'm actually trying to cycle past. And then I had to pull out into the lane to pass it. The last sort of 30 kilometres was pretty savage. It was really steep. Every time there was a hill, it was a very steep hill. And then I thought, that's it, that's going to be the last one. And then there was another one. And then my legs hurt and thought, well, that's it, that's got to be it. I've got to go downhill now. And then there was another one. The last 2 hours was brutal.
This is day three of the challenge. Let's see how his preparations for this morning are going. Morning, Mr. Wood.
Morning.
Very How's good. The bike looking?
Bike is looking good. I've just had to adjust the brakes a little bit.
And yeah.
Make sure I've got the wheels turning well.
So uh-huh.
I think. And of course, my bell doesn't work. Well, it sort of works.
Okay.
But I think we're good to go.
Okay, so, well, best of luck then.
Thank you very much.
And we'll see you on the other side.
Right, off we go.
Could take a while.
Good luck.